Hey guys, we're here back with another episode of Dungeon Defenders 2. And today we are going to solo on Incursion Nightmare 4 map. So, let's pick our map. Now, the one that I found worked for me, actually it's the only one that I've tried. It's this one here. So let us create a game. And do a private game. And create. So, the, I'm only going to be really using three of my characters, and that is Lavamancer, the, Abyss Lord, and the Monk. So, I also have Eevee too, but, I'm not going to be using her. Whee! But yeah, I'm gonna also be running, by the time this video is up, I think I will do a giveaway on the Lavamancer. Trendy was kind enough to give me some codes for the Lavamancer, so I will do a giveaway for one of them. So I will put a link in the description of this video on how to win the Lavamancer. And thank you for Trendy for sending me that code. Because without them I wouldn't be able to, well, let's go. Yeah. I'll put that there. Now I'm gonna set this up the way that this worked for me. There's probably a lot more optimal ways of doing this. But, this is what I found worked. I found it best to keep everything as close as possible together. Because the main thing we need to do is buff. Oops. Buff all of our, towers and all that with the Lavamancer's ability. Good. Up, up. Here. Good. Good. Okay. And after I set this all up, I'll show you what my stats are. Last time I tried this, hardly anybody made it to the wall. It was just the suicide guys that made it to the walls. And I'm gonna put this here because here sometimes little healing guy, those little crystal healing guys up here there, are they drop down there, so. Good. And I'm just gonna show you real quick my stats. There. I also have the spheres. This one here is pretty much key. This one here is kind of useless, but I put it in there anyways. You. That. That's useless. That's useless for what I'm doing. That's kind of useless, but. Yeah. And my stats, which is just basically attack. Attack rate and range. Oh, I also forgot to show something else. That. But yeah, and the key items are like the purge evil. I need that. Idle flow. It's pretty good too. That slows me down. And as for you, and that really matters, is explosive art arrows. It helps actually quite a bit. And for him, the Tephra bomb, it helps actually, yeah, it does help quite a bit. Same with the other ability there, the fossilizer. That helps too. So the strategy is basically stand here and buff everything. That is how this works. So I like to wait until this thing starts shooting and then I buff it. Because it buffs these guys too. So again, grab my lava ball. Now, you could technically use a volcano for defense. I think it's a wall. I personally don't recommend it. Because what's the difference? That this one here is 400, and this one is 100. I love the petrification stuff. It helps so much. Not only are you taking a guy out, but with the correct spheres, the enemies attack the sphere itself, so you have that working for you. And with the correct spheres, they'll actually explode and damage people around them. So that helps too, and it's a blockade. That ball. And it. So what I like to upgrade first is the volcano itself, just because it has such a massive range. I like to upgrade these at least once. Actually, I like upgrading these at least once. These are priority two. Upgrade those, because technically one suicider can take out the crystal. I've had it happen before. It's not fun. You can see tons of damage. I think the most I've ever brought one of these guys up. Now it's not mine, but it was somebody else's. It was like at 300,000 or something like that. Oh wait, never mind. It must have been more, because I just brought mine up to 4. As I know, the blockade boosters don't actually work on these guys unless they patched that. Oh no! Up recently. It's not good. Bro, you took that down to half health. Okay. Whew. Tried that happen before where they... This actually happens quite a bit. Where they get stuck or something like that. Let's just upgrade stuff, gather stuff. I'm gonna upgrade right now my AA. That's good. Let's upgrade here. Good. That's good. Oh, I forgot something. So much. I didn't have as many problems last time. This time I can. Doing fine. Another burst. Get underground. Like what? But yeah, if you had more guys here, I think you can kill these things off. Oh yeah, I killed him. Okay. So you don't have to kill, from what I noticed, you don't have to kill the healing guys. You do have to kill everybody else. I could also teleport to Volcano. Sometimes it's a pain to put it back. So, I don't. So far so good though, I mean, this is really suicide guys that are getting through. Keep getting through! Dead. What is this? Oh, not what I want. I mean, it's a good weapon, but not for how I use it. You. Let's see now. If you want to look, my Volcano 387 kills. Oops. Okay, let's just. Explode! that's not good. Okay, she's dead. Down, where's this one coming from? Behind. I'm gonna try, not this video, but maybe another video, see if I can actually completely solo a map just with him and just his towers. It might, I think it'll be doable. See that? And let's see, what do we get here? That does not stack with, if you have two of those Tefra bombs, don't stack. I tried. Nope. Nope. Get the same bow that I got before. This is... Nope. What I'm looking for is basically what I'm wearing right now. Crystallized Magma and Pyroclast. I want those two. At least. Show me... That. Yeah. Ooh. There's another thing here. No, I'm gonna hold on to that one. Study it. Think about it. Anyways, guys, that's going to be it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye!